You won't believe what I just heard.
You won't believe what I just heard.
Zar, you don't believe what I just heard.
Okay, come on. So we are off now. The game goes now, yeah?
You won't believe what just heard.
All right, okay. Okay. Right, the game gets a little bit more complicated now, okay? So it needs to be quicker. Yeah, so the second someone gets to you, you have to leave and go somewhere else. But this time, you have to do a gesture with every single word. Every single word. You won't believe what I just heard. Yeah? Every single word has an action to it.
I'd like you to join your ideas together. A small abstract of an article, what you would write for being a teenager in a school newspaper. What would you want to say to the people about it? Few words, no more, no big text, we don't have the time for that. Write down, please, for me, one paper for a group. Then I collect your ideas, your paper.
In 5 minute timer over. When the 3 minute timer runs out, put the egg in the boiling water. When the 5 minute timer runs out, 2 minutes have elapsed and it is time to take the egg out of the water. You don't need the 4 minute timer for this
It's 22:13. It's 22:13.
Oh no, it's just one.
Yeah, just put the fire in the bottle and then you like push the egg so it's gonna light and then put the egg on top and then it slides.
Yeah.
Just try this.
Yeah.
So like put the fire here and then put the fire in there.
Sorry, darling.
And then push it right now.
No, push it right now.
Oh,
yeah.
Guys.
Yeah. Yeah. More.
Back.
And the egg, yeah. The egg.
Put the egg on, put the egg
on. No, it has to be
on fire.
Listen.
No, it's like
now, call the queen. First team, you managed to do that.
Good.
l'abbiamo seggio.
Ok, no.
Can you put it down? Can you put it down?
My lady, it's rubbish.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Please, to explain why the water is not suction.
Shall I come up?
Yes. When you, yeah. Come here. Why the water does not
So when you turn the glass upside down, the air that was in the top there flips over from the boots of the top of the glass and acts as a vacuum which sucks the paper up.
Yeah.
The jury.
Yep.
They had most of the points, actually. Show me your prize.
That's a prize.
In that way, I hope to give them a little bit of feeling that I can contribute, even if I don't know the correct answer, I can still say something and be a part of the solution. And we do play a little bit more differently because the real game you play individually, we play in teams of five. So, my name is Alexandra, and you are?
Emanuela, from Sweden, Steven, and Roman. And we used to play this game, but we played it in groups because we're like one class. And we only played with math questions, but today we're gonna play, we're gonna start with four Swedish questions, like questions from Sweden, and then we're gonna
show you a couple of examples of the math problems we use.
Yeah.
So, we need five volunteers to play the game. One, two, three, two more. So, in the game, if you've been watching the show before, earlier, you know that the team could have three lifelines. So, some of you have got on your seats answering sheets. Okay? So you're gonna be, if the team needs help and wants to ask the audience, you're the one showing your answers. Okay? And we also need five people to be the lifeline call a friend. And for those of you who have iPhones or smartphones and can use the internet, you can use the internet as well. So we need five volunteers to be the group of call a friend. Once. Come on, we need four more. Two. Teachers, you can participate as well if you want to.
Okay. Okay. Orlando.
Our background is that physics as a rhythm and as patterns, like maths. We have here some phrases of a book of Feynman. Feynman is an American great scientist who died, but is one of the greatest scientists of the 20th century. And he writes this.
Even the artists appreciate sunsets and the ocean waves and the march of the stars across the sky. There is then some reason to talk sometimes of other things. As we look into these things, we get an aesthetic pleasure from them directly from observation. There is also a rhythm and a pattern between the phenomena of nature, which is not apparent to the eye, but only to the eye of analysis. And it's these rhythms and patterns which we call physical laws.
Today you are understanding something about the patterns that are behind the laws of physics. And in maths, in algebra, you have patterns too. And so they are the same. They need maths needs physics, and physics needs maths.
Mm-hmm. Algebra is an indispensable tool for problem solving in science, and although algebraic expressions are simplified expressions of natural language, to be fluent in science requires the ability to translate concepts from natural language into algebraic expressions and translate algebraic expressions into natural language.
Now we are you go to the computers, do some activities. Two students for computer or three. Please come back. You can create anything in any language.
Using
learningapps.org.
And we are all making an account now.
The system generates the QR code and you just...
But where's the app there? Which one?
Best students.
Good. Natasa? What are we making, Natasa?
No, they don't want to listen, but they captives. And at the end...
Have you tried this before?
No, I haven't tried it before. And a lot of it's in French, so I'm kind of trying to understand it.
Isn't it in English?
Did you pick the wrong...
No, I picked English.
Oh.
I've got the British flag highlighted.
Rachel, what about you?
It looks good. I've never used it before, though.
We use Google Classroom a lot.
Yes.
But I've never made my own app. And that's great, like, specific to my subjects. So, yeah, it's be good.
Okay, have you used this before, guys?
No.
No? Sounds interesting, looks interesting, yes? You're generating questions?
Yes. Maybe.
Mats, are you going to use it?
I haven't used it yet, so I don't know.
As an idea. Are you going to use it in class? Do you think it's going to be helpful?
We are still trying to find out how it works.
Good.
But it looks interesting.
Sometimes that you can use using physics or chemistry and to be a millionaire.
When you click on so, for example, and it gives you three examples to see what it looks like and does it work for you, for your subject or not.
It's
if
like
you like it, you're going to create
let
your app.
Let me just check.
Okay.
It's
like
it's very interesting.
Okay.
It's like...
Okay, click on one of them. And it gives you three examples of already created such games to see how it looks like. And if you want to make your game, you click on create new app.
You choose the three options. One of the three options.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
create new app.
Wait.
Okay. You can put a title there of the exercise to find it easier.
You're quick. Do you use it in class?
No.
No? Margarita.
Look at what is going on. It's giving me this.
Eleni?
It's giving me this in Greek. Yes,
why
yes,
would
yes.
In Greek?
Because you chose the language.
No, I chose English.
They saw you face reading. They know you're Greek.
No, it's, I don't know. It doesn't.
Michael got it in French. She got it in Greek without selecting.
Are you getting it in French? We just switch around.
Something spooky is going on.
You can use pictures. Lucky.
That's for good luck.
Yes. Because the question is,
no, it's yes. Insisting on doing
the
everything.
Explain what is the word.
Ah. So teachers are busy now, learning new tools, e-tools, can use in our teaching.
And then you can create this QR.
QR.
So if you don't like your app, you can go.
Save your app that has been saved successfully. You can find it in my app.
And look at the little circle, just a second, with the tip.
One group here worked well and produced something. And I'm going to check out everyone. I'm supposed to make QR codes. Everyone is so good. So you pick a question.
Texan.
Select image. How's it going?
No, I don't.
Good. Working? Bravo.
Yes. Bravo.
And you did Lisbon, lovely.
Something.
So, you see your app, you gotta click save this app, and it's okay.
Save, okay.
Save it and you have it there. Ah, oh, that's nice. Did you do anything?
Yeah, I did. You can use this in all school subjects.
Works well.
Even yes. In English also. Language.
Yeah. Yeah.
And now just intense. You go with what is meaning of the world.
Or some information, yes. Something. Yes. Yes.
And this is the first time that I recommend.
Guys, how did it go? Did something nice?
Oh, no, we're trying. We're still trying.
Trying, okay. Alexandra?
I made one and it worked.
Good.
I did a crossword. Ah.
Let's see. You want to show it?
Yeah, I need to find it.
Learn apps.
This one. It's a little bit, the system's a little bit slow.
Okay.
So I did this one with a couple of words and then I just copyrighted it.
Did you manage to make your fears?
Okay. Yes, the system
is you through and connects
yeah.
To that.
Well, it's slow, so. So what actually it connects me to the crossword I just made.
Mm.
So it's just quite
so
easy.
We need internet connection on our phone.
No, I do have internet, it's just that it's really, really slow. So just
so you can read it without internet.
Yeah.
Good.
You just click the question.
Needs time to log it. Thank you, Alexandra.
You're welcome.
Did you enjoy it?
Yes, I did.
More interesting in the history classroom.
Yeah.
And they make research to find, if they type in Google Bulgarian anthem, they will see that the name of that person is Svetlana Vladislavov. They have to answer a few questions about him, when did he create the song, and things like that. Mm-hmm. And if you
detail, so you can use those ideas if you want to in your school. Okay, the project was called
Biology.
It's how to integrate experimental science and music, which is not always easy because, as you explained before, maths and physics are always quite linked. But how to integrate this with music was challenging.
And your subject is?
My subject is biology.
Okay.
And here I have Luis, Mar, and also Kayla. They have participated in this project, and maybe it's interesting. You can ask them some questions if you want to. Not very difficult. Okay. First of all, in our school we have this special space in the schedule for project module, and this is the main help for us, because I don't have biology, students don't have biology, students don't have music, they have project time in their schedule. And we are organized in three sessions. First one, 2 hours, which is not the same as in the rest of subjects, and then 1 hour and 1 hour, okay? And so there, in that space, we integrate biology, physics, chemistry, and also music. These are some of the contents you can work in this project. These are from science area, acoustic waves, kinetic theory, brain anatomy, nervous system, and also these music contents. What is sound, the qualities of sound, families of instruments. Well, Nectarius maybe can can specify more. And some competences. We work not only in this project, but in all of them. Like autonomy, teamwork, creativity, speaking skills, self-organization.
The base group. Where we work like with a folder. Yes, and it's about the connection between science and music, all in general. Then when we finish this part, every member of the group individually can choose if they prefer to be the brainers, the luthiers, or the big sound theory. That were the three parts that you can choose for the exhibition project.
Mm-hmm. This is the general folder, so they can follow it. They have some videos and some activities. Also some apps. For example, this one called Audacity, in which you register your voice and then you can see the waves. Mm-hmm. It's very, very graphic.
Mm-hmm. And depending on what you prefer or what you are talented, you choose the one that is better for you. For example, Luthiers is the one who made the instrument with things you can do. We can do it, not like professional instrument. And the brainers work about what part of the brain is working when you hear a sound. Mar is going to explain it better then. And then the big sound theory did like the vibration or the acoustic waves.
production. Ah, fuck! Come on, we need a brown one! Oh, God!
Please stick with Elen.
What about your skin production?
Yes.
How's it going here? Ah, oh, layers. Not bad.
Let's make the last.
Yeah, we still need the last
one. Just a moment.
You can do
so much. I go around. This is the
bridge. Come on, Peter, not the one.
And skin closed. Time's up. You have to show us your work.
What will we do that? Close it.
Yeah, close it. Close
it. Close it. Close it. Close
it.
Close it.
Okay, this one is done.
Bravo! Bravo! Let's see how much. Let's see.
And the last one.
Come on,
show us.
Woo! Bravo!
Okay. That's a good part. Any more? Ah, that's the winning team?
What?
Or they all get a lolly?
How good we call them? Because they're
all winners. Bravo, Natasa. Natasa. A reward for everyone.
Play contest winner. Cyprus wrote this play. It's a modern story of Romeo and Juliet, and it was the winner in the competition. And there are members from each of the competing schools as part of this cast. They've only had 1 hour to put this together, so they've done a really good job to put this together in an hour. I ask you to be quiet. Obviously, laugh if you find it funny. But to be quiet, because we don't have microphones, so they need to be heard right at the very back, okay? Let's give them a round of applause. Here we go.
She has applied. I think you're a very unique person.
Oh my God.
Very creative, full of ideas.
You're a very unique person, and we're here because of you, because you've done this and you could get all things together. And so,
now I will fly.
Natasha, are we going to? The aims and of the project, and after that, one of the ideas was to put for each country, but I haven't done anything yet.
So it's sampling. You could have words, you could have anything you want, and that's how you play it free. And it's only for iOS, unfortunately. So iPads and iPhones. Other applications, I'm going to talk about this in Cyprus because we need internet. Sampling applications that we're going to talk and discuss free. You could use it in the lesson as a break for the students.
Activities. So I let him go on with his partner, they enjoyed it. Then they rehearsed. I just took photos there. And there were three of them or four of them in each case. Up here you see the patient is down here, the ill person, and the other ones are suggesting ways out and they're really having fun. Okay, and then we moved on. We went into our amphitheater with one of the groups.
Yo tengo que ir a la casa.